Hi everybody, this is Dr. A, and I have created a video that has a concept that I come up with, and it's explaining the red cell indices with jars and beads. So here we go. So as a reminder, the red cell indices will help assess red cell characteristics as part of a CBC, and they're useful in evaluating the cause of anemias, which is usually not enough red cells, polycythemias, which is too many red cells, and nutritional disorders. So we're thinking like maybe iron deficiency, anemia, or deficiency in B12 and folate. So first one is immune cell volume, usually the first one reported after the red count, hemoglobin, hematocrit. And so the MCV is an estimate of the average volume of red cells in femtoliters. So this, in our illustration, corresponds to the size of the jar. So the jar represents the red cell, and so let's say this is a normal size red cell, normal size jar. This is a smaller one, this is a larger one. So the smaller ones are going to be called microcytes. They have a decreased MCV because they have a smaller volume, because they're a smaller container, a smaller jar. And the most common cause of microcytosis is going to be iron deficiency anemia. The abnormally large ones have an increased MCV. They're bigger jars, they have a bigger volume, and they're called macrocytes. And they are generally seen with vitamin B12 deficiency and or folate deficiency. So next we have the mean cell hemoglobin, or the MCH. And this is the average weight of the hemoglobin in the red cells. And this is in picograms. So if you will, in this illustration, it's the weight of the beads in the jar. So the beads are representing the molecules of hemoglobin. The jar represents the red cell. And so I had fun weighing them here. And so, for example, if this is a normal red cell with a normal amount of hemoglobin, that would be the weight. Now, of course, this is not accurate because this is actually the weight of the jar in the beads, but just for an illustration. And then this is a smaller red cell, but it's pretty full of the hemoglobin, so it represents a smaller one, so you can see how its weight is lower. And then this would be the same size cell as this one, but with even less hemoglobin in there. So you can see the weight is different. I just removed some of the beads to represent maybe, a lower content of hemoglobin into that size. So sometimes you can have smaller red cells, but they're full of hemoglobin. And sometimes you can have smaller red cells and they're not full of hemoglobin. And so decreased MCH, so that decreased weight, is often seen in iron deficiency anemia. And in iron deficiency anemia, you also have the smaller jars, the microsize, the smaller cells. But if they can be smaller and have a normal amount, of a normal weight, or for that size anyway, and they will look the right color. But if they don't have as much hemoglobin in them, then they'll look pale, even though, even if these two are the same size. Okay, so that kind of helps you hopefully wrap your mind around all of that. And I don't have it illustrated here, but for example, increased MCH, so cells that are heavier, that have more hemoglobin in them, could be seen with folate deficiency. Now, the third one is the MCHC, which is the mean cell hemoglobin concentration. It's the average amount of hemoglobin per volume of red cell. So it takes into account the weight of the hemoglobin, but also the volume, the size of the cell. So it takes into account the amount of beads versus the volume, the size of the jar. Okay. So weight of beads per volume of a jar is an example, an illustration of concentration, the concentration of the MCHC value. And so this is normally calculated by dividing the hemoglobin by the hematocrit. And iron deficiency anemia is the only anemia in which the MCHC is routinely low. This represents here, for example, a normal concentration of an MCHC, even though if you remember, these jars are representing the microsize, the smaller cell, versus a low concentration. So we have less beads for the same volume here, and that would be then representing a low MCHC. And then the last of the indices is the RDW, which is the red blood cell distribution width, and it's an indication of the variation of red cell size, and it's indicated in percent. And so in our example, that would be a variation in the size of the jars or the size of the red cells. So, for example, in this one, we have this one representing normal cells and then some small ones. So we have some variation. So that would cause an increase in the percentage of the RDW because there's variation in the size of the jars. But then this one, you can see all of the jars are the same size. So that would, in that one, you would have a normal RDW. And then in this one, it would be even more because you have a really big jar, a small jar, and a normal jar, and you have a bunch of those. So that would be an even bigger RDW than this one, for example. So where that can be useful is it can help you distinguish iron deficiency anemia, which would have an RDW because it would have some normal and some microcytes. So you'd have variations in sizes of your red cells from a thalassemia, which have either a normal or a low RDW. So all your cells are pretty consistently the same. They may all be small, all microcytes, but they're all consistently made the same. And so it would have a normal RDW. And then, you know, can represent, you know, more severe problems in red cell morphology where you have all kinds of variations. And so, for example, one that would have really high RDW would be, for example, sickle cell crisis. And we have all kinds of weird shapes and sizes of red cells. So anyway, so there you go. That's my concept of jars and beads and red cell indices. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next video.